Hello everybody. Today I have a look at three folders from Magnum. Magnum is the value brand of Boker. They are made in China. They cost typically something between the price of, let's say, in a universal unit, one to maximum three CDs. So they are most of them. So they are really aimed at the value for money level. Often also available, what I notice at least here in Europe, in outdoor shops where people who will occasionally use a knife, so not for knifeness you could say, buy a knife. And in line with the value approach, actually the steel of them is usually 440A, which is these days a pretty basic steel that works reasonably well, but you have to sharpen it more often as some of the more high-end steels like are typically used by for example Spyderco, etc. So this being the value brand, the step above you could say is the Boker Plus series, which are usually made in Taiwan, sometimes made in China, and where the steel typically is 440C or AOS-8, so somewhat a step above, a decent mid-range steel. The Boker Plus series is perhaps the most dynamic of the Boker brands. They have a lot of interesting designs. And then there's a classic Boker brand with high-end folders, but also very classical folders. So just to position these. Now, well, actually I have 4 or maybe even 5 Magnums, but these I think are the 3 only really interesting of them. So, 2 recent ones and one which is roughly a year old. So the ones that I'm looking at here is the M, as you can see, with the M here on the button. And then here 2 recent ones, actually the Tuscany with the sheep foot blade, and here the Tech folder with, can you believe it, for Magnum carbon fiber handle inlays. So, first a look here at the M. Well, I can already say one thing, which is the same for all of the 3 folders. I honestly think that these Magnum folders are pretty well made. The 3 that I have here, there is really no play on the blade. It's really nicely made. So yes, it's made in China, which makes it cheap, but you cannot say that the build quality really suffers. Really the one area where really money has been saved is rather that the blade, as I mentioned, is pretty low end, but okay for occasional use. Also considering the price, these are fun gifts for people who can appreciate a knife but are not necessarily knife maniacs. So here the M type is around 80 grams heavy, I thought, around 6 centimeter blade, or 6 yes, so a good 2.5 inches, and it's actually a liner lock, but you have to press the button here to get the liner out of the way. It's a one-hand knife with, you could say, a bit of Spyderco bird-like opening, but I don't think you can say it's a copy. The handle material is a kind of an anodized aluminium. So it is quite a fun, sturdy little utility folder. I think it is pretty charming. You cannot move the blade, the handle around. There are some holes here that you could argue are to help to reduce weight. I think they are more to make it a bit more a fashionable object. I think this is pretty sweet. Now, the Tuscany. Well, I immediately liked this one when I saw it in among the new Boker knives that were launched. So it is actually quite similar in look and feel, I think, to my beloved modern Italian pocket knives from, let's say, Mazarin. But it's a bit heavier made. The Italian pocket knives tend to be a bit more slender. This being said, I think this is quite a fun general use knife. So a sheepfoot is a knife, as you can see. The difference between a Wharncliffe and a sheepfoot is that the sheepfoot stays, the top of the blade stays horizontal almost longer and only at the end drops. So it is a relatively safe kind of blade because it's not suited for piercing. So in that context, it's quite safe. It's less, you will less easily have an accident with it. But it is the kind of blade that you have here with almost flat at the bottom. It allows for fun general use utilities. And you can also use it pretty well for food because it's it's 3 mm at the top. I forgot to say that here about the other one, which is also around 3 mm, but and a hollow ground, but very high the hollow ground. So it is actually quite good at the table, let's say, or you could say as an when you're having a picnic or cook outside. Well, why not? It uses a liner lock, which is well adjusted. You see it's here to the left, and again there's no play to it. The opening is a bit less smooth than some of my better knives, so maybe I need to oil it a bit, but I mean, there's nothing really to worry about. It's screwed together, so if you really want to, you can open it. The pivot area has this kind of a star here, which is a bit amusing. The wood, I don't know what the wood is. In the Boker catalog, they say it's a Mediterranean wood. Well, it looks a bit like Bocote, I don't know. It's not really olive wood, it's too dark for that, but it is really nicely made. Eh? And the sides here are nicely rounded. It's nicely flush here with the bolster. So, well, it could have been a bit better, but still, it's pretty okay. I really think, again, well, it's value for money. It's a price of 1.5 CD or so, it's this one. I think this is pretty convincing, actually, and pretty good looking. The third one, it resembles a tiny bit my wonderful Klotzi 05, which is of course more expensive with this particular blade form. So this is more the high-tech modern looking folder that they offer. I think honestly this looks really good. It is absolutely nothing wrong with the looks of it. Also a hollow ground, quite thin here so at the bottom, so which allows for really good slicing ability. Even here at the top it's a 3 mm. So it's all I always prefer a full flat ground, because what you can have with hollow grounds, when you would for example cut through cardboard, the top can get a bit in the way, so which is a bit annoying. But in general and also for food, this is pretty good actually. So for occasional use, I think if you give this to somebody, I think they will be impressed. It looks good. The carbon fiber inlay is nicely flush. It's really nicely made here. So you have the anodized grey metal bolsters, metal liner, weer hier de liner lock, en dan de carbon fiber inlays. There are variants of this one with G10 and with the dark wood inlay. So they all look good actually. So thumb stud opening, really it's a one hand, classical one hand knife, but it looks pretty well. What to summarize actually, the time that you should love with, you could say, the Chinese build quality when it comes to knives is really beyond us. I think you cannot say that they are badly made. it is even true that some high-end companies now offer knives made under their own, in their own name, that are made in China, which shows that these days the production quality is really pretty good if you follow it up closely enough. And here I think what Boker does here, offering knives for, let's say, everyone can afford this, up to a pretty good standard. I think it's admirable actually, and they look also good. So why buy yourself a cheap ugly copy of a popular knife and you have something original that's pretty decent? I was wondering even for people who are into making knives, and well, I'm not, I don't have the tools, I would like to try it, but I don't have the tools. I think it, some of these designs, it would be fun actually to reuse the handle and actually grind yourself a blade from a better steel, because the rest of the blade, as I mentioned, is pretty standard. It's okay, but a bit standard average for occasional use, pretty okay. The rest of the build quality and the handle is always very convincing. So, good. I hope you found this interesting. Three knives with a pretty different character from Magnum. Feel free to leave feedback.